I know you're out there. I can feel you now. I know that you're afraid. You're afraid of us. You're afraid of change. I don't know the future. I didn't come here to tell you how this is going to end. I came here to tell you how it's going to begin. I'm going to hang up this phone, and then I'm going to show these people what you don't want them to see. I'm going to show them a world without you. A world without rules and controls, without borders or boundaries. A world where anything is possible. Where we go from there is a choice I leave to you.
There ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. When I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise right out of the ground. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. Well, look way down the river, and what do you think I see? I see a band of angels, and they're coming after me. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. Well, look down yonder, Gabriel. Put your feet on the land and sea. But Gabriel, don't you blow your trumpet till you hear from me. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. Well, meet me, Jesus, meet me. Meet me in the middle of the air. And if these wings don't fail me, I will meet you anywhere. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. Well, meet me, mother and father. Meet me down the river road. And mama, you know that I'll be there when I check in, my Lord. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down.
Let's look at Northern California. You understand?
Yeah.
You know what's happening in
San Francisco. Just gone. It's clear over.
I know that, but it isn't. It isn't just down in the ratty part of town.
No.
But the upper class in San Francisco is that way.
Yeah.
The Bohemian Grove that I attend from time to time. The Easterners and the others that come there. But it is the most faggy goddamn thing you can ever imagine in San Francisco crowd, because it's just terrible. I mean, I can always shake hands with anybody in San Francisco.
While in New York, we ran into the Karl Rove of four administrations. David Gergen, top presidential advisor to Ford, Reagan, George Herbert Walker Bush, and Bill Clinton. We couldn't believe our luck. It just so happens that David Gergen is also a prominent member of the Bohemian Grove, the offshoot of Skull and Bones. This insider of insiders, a staple of the White House for 22 years, got very upset when we brought up Bohemian Grove to him. He didn't deny its existence. He didn't deny that he was a member. He didn't deny the rituals. He just became angry and didn't act very gentlemanly.
Listen, I am a happy member of the Bohemian Grove. I like the folks who come there. And it's really inappropriate for me to talk about the group beyond that. Thank you.
Have you been there for the ceremony with the cremation of care?
Frankly, I don't think that's something I need to talk to you about.
For 3 hours of Bohemia, we thank thee for thy adjuration.
Have you been there for the ceremony with the cremation of care?
Frankly, I don't think that's something I need to talk to you about.
Really?
That's right.
Well, I'm Alex Jones, and I snuck in there in 2000. I'm the guy that blew it wide open
and got the video and spit on national TV.
Well, I disrespect you for that.
You do?
I do.
But there's a lot of big public officials going in there. Don't we deserve to know?
I don't know anything about you, and I don't know anything about your film. But if you go in there with an understanding, you violated that understanding by releasing that film, and I don't respect you for that.
Really?
You took an understanding when you went in there that you would not do that film. And you did you have an understanding when you went in there?
No.
Did you crash it?
Yes.
Yeah, and it has no trespassing signs there, too, doesn't it?
No, they put them up after.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, sir. I've been there before. I know what the circumstances are, and I'm sorry you violated the understandings. That was not a gentlemanly thing to do.
But what about the ritual? Is the ritual gentlemanly?
Sir, everything I don't owe you this comment.
I know.
This is what's called ambush journalism, and I disrespect you for that as well. So thank you and goodbye.
Have you ever been in the ritual?
That's none of your damn business.
Oh.
Conspiracy.